Hi, my name is Zul. My team and I won first place in IBM's 2019 Core Vocal Challenge last year. I'm now currently serving as a rotor commander at SCDF Central Fire Station, responding to emergencies.
Hi, my name is Adam. I'm a student at the Singapore University of Technology and Design. My team and I from SUTD came in second place at the 2018 SCDF Lifesavers Innovation Challenge.
So for Core Vocal 2019, we actually had to build a solution that improves an emergency response. We could use cloud, data, analytics, IoT, or any other solution to improve natural disaster preparedness, response, or recovery using IBM technologies all within 24 hours. So during natural disasters, the call lines will actually be flooded with callers trying to report information, and some of the calls will actually no doubt be missed due to the high volume. Automation and optimization was an ideal solution to this problem. So our solution was actually to use artificial intelligence to automatically answer concurrent 95 calls. It would then transcribe the caller's voice from speech to text and identify keywords such as bleeding or location. It would then actually aggregate the information into an easy-to-see interactive dashboard for operators to use. Sentiment analysis will also be done on the voice to indicate urgency. Then, each incident will then be given a priority, which will then be given to operators to deploy resources efficiently.
The theme for 2018's competition was on SCDF's resource constraints. We were to enhance their operational capabilities through innovative technology. I felt a lot of passion, and the driving factor is the experience I had during National Service when I served as a firefighter, and I turned up for a call when my breathing apparatus stopped working. Before the fire, and it suddenly malfunctioned and stopped providing air. So from this personal experience, I wanted to improve and reduce human error as much as possible. Hence our solution was to create an IoT device to keep track and broadcast firefighters' air consumption outside of the danger zone in real time.
There was definitely a learning curve using the IBM technologies such as Bluemix and Watson. So we essentially had to learn as we were coding, which caused quite a few snags when we were building our solution.
It was difficult to find parts for the prototypes we were trying to make, so we had to understand normal procedures and industry standards taken to make such a device. We did a lot of interviews and site visits with manufacturers to learn more about making such devices. In order to overcome the obstacles, we had to do extensive research, establishing proper understanding between consumers and stakeholders for the project.
So the IBM mentors at the hackathon were actually very knowledgeable, helpful, and extremely patient with our questions. Of course, having talented teammates with synergy and multidisciplinary skills never hurt as well.
In this case, I think our work was a contribution to SCDF in a way that it made people think about and engineer solutions for problems around us. I could see people making changes, becoming keener to adopt things they've thought of, and embracing innovation.
In the near future, I foresee that emergency response departments all over the world will be using some form of real-time analysis of emergency data, something similar to what we have done. So through our solution, we actually hope that it actually inspires other creators to improve on it, or actually better yet, go beyond what we have done and tackle another problem. So less is more. You don't have to jam too many features or technologies into a solution just for the sake of it. Instead, build something that's actually useful and for a common good.
So my advice is, don't be afraid. If you feel that you have a solution that might work, pursue it. Who knows, you might even design something that you'll be proud of.